Alright, welcome back. This is Imdog. We are leveling together here. I did get some advice on some spots here at Oldburg for Bream. So we're going to try out some things. I think we've still got pretty much our Bream set up. And it's raining, so we may even go ahead and put these in earlier than normal and just see what we're getting. So this Laggy C is the one that recommended this spot for Bream. And then Triple Hatch also recommended some spot down over here, like in G7. Looks like casting into this hole also for Bream. So we'll see if we have time to test both. We may just look at one this time, and maybe we'll try the other one next time. But I have certainly fished in this spot before. In fact, it wasn't that long ago that this spot was good, so I'm surprised it's good again. Maybe it never stopped being good, but let's give it a spin here and see what we can find out. But I'm hoping with the rain and the overcast, maybe we'll even start to get some early bream, but we'll see. All we can do is try it. I made some coffee and it's got like a cinnamon flavor to it. It's okay. I think I just really like regular coffee. Whenever there's flavors, it's not as good to me. So I'm working tonight. It's possible that we could get interrupted here while I'm making this video, but in an ideal world, I'd like to be able to do a one RF4 video and one fishing plant video, but we'll see if there's time. Someone else also mentioned on the second map, so I'm assuming they meant Winding Rivulet 3549. I don't really know where that would be or what even you're fishing for. They didn't give very much information, but if you are watching this and want to provide more information on that spot, we can try it. But let's pull up our map thing and go to Winding Rivulet and just even see where that is. What did I say, 3549? That's not a spot here, is it? I wonder if he meant...
Wow.
35... Yeah, that's not Oldburg either, so maybe it's Mosquito? That is a spot at Mosquito, right on the shore there. Is that the spot on Mosquito that we catch all those trophy Chinese sleepers and crucians and gibbles and stuff? Maybe that's what he was referring to, but he did say second map, so that's the weird part. Second map meaning Mosquito. He's counting Cottage Pond as a map. Okay. Well, I mean, we could try that spot. That spot definitely has been. Are there any weeklies on Mosquito for any of that stuff? So, like, Chinese Sleeper. Looks like Nightcrawlers might still be working. Those were today at Mosquito. And then what about the Gibbles? Garlic Dough and Mosquitoes. I mean, sorry, Garlic Dough and Nightcrawlers for Mosquito. What about Crucians? Honey Dough. Vanilla 14. Wet Bread. Huh. Okay. Yeah, maybe it is worth trying that. I do enjoy when mosquitoes popping off. All right, that's a good sign. As long as those bream get bigger once it's nighttime. There's a white. Okay. I'll see what the health of the RF4 forums are today. Not much being posted about the low-level lakes. Looks like amber. The new lake is still a little bit hit or miss for people. Oh, this coffee. I just can't do it. White bream. Hopefully this is also a white variety. Nope. Getting up to that 9 out of 10 ground bait. Well, we're getting there on the time that it should start. Is that lightning? The time that it should really start picking up here. Oh, that's interesting. We call it a common roach. Yeah, we need to make some semolina, don't we? Just every time we get on, we need to make a few stacks of it to keep working on leveling that. So the first mark is at 20, which is in about 10 in-game minutes. You should start to see a little bit of improvement there, and then the next mark is at 2200. And by then, if you're not starting to see markers, then your spot's in trouble. This is going to be a marker, I believe. Almost. But that was definitely an improvement. And that happened right at 20. Again, another one that's a little bigger now that we're past 20. So far, all good signs. That's a roach. Never mind. At least we're making money off that roach, unlike the non-marker bream. So we've had a marker bream, a marker white bream, and then two roach. And we're at 210 silver. Nice white. With this rod, we could start trying to target carp, especially here at Old Berg or at Mosquito. They're not too big, usually. Maybe fish with potatoes down in the pond area. I don't know. Bring on the markers. All right, so we're 30 in-game minutes away from the next mark of 2200. It's really weird. I guess it's just the weight of the... feeder and ground bait, but this just looked weird to me. There's a nice one. Hopefully. We'll see him pop off now. Oh, they do have a trophy section on the forum. I never saw that. Oh, that's because... oh, okay. They started at January 11th. So close, yet so far away. I feel like this rod, or this rod and reel combo, just does not cast as far. Obviously this one would cast farther, but even this one, is it the length? This one is 4 meters. This one is 3.9 meters. Maybe it is the length. I can really tell a difference. Oh, wow. This seems to be a nice fish. It's okay. They do seem to be getting a little bigger now past midnight. We're not breaking the bank yet, though. Or filling the bank, I should say. Nice fish, I think. I think this will be up around a kilo, maybe. Should be. Yeah. Oh. Now that's interesting. A trophy common roach. Huh. Not what I was expecting. It's one thing to catch little 400 gram bream when you're fishing outside of the ideal time. But when you catch a 400 gram bream at 1:20 in the morning, that's pretty disappointing. I wonder if garlic dough would work better. Mm-hmm. That's the problem, boys and girls. We don't have garlic dough. So if you have garlic dough unlocked, or if someone has given you garlic dough, that probably would work significantly better. So we need semolina, milk, and sugar. Whoa. Oh. It's an even bigger roach. Just kidding. Chances are this actually is a bream. All right, our first real bream. We may have to go to Mosquito just to make enough silver to level up our ground bait. Semolina. Sugar. Can we use pasteurized milk? That's the question. We can. All right. So we can use pasteurized milk. All right. So we'll see where that gets us while we're fishing, and then maybe next time if we can get lucky on points. I don't know. We'll see. We need to get up to garlic dough. It's the bottom line here. Oh, wow. All right, that's 34%. There's no way we don't have a fish on. Somewhere, right? I forget how forgiving the points calculator is at lower levels. All right. We make garlic dough and cheese cubes now. I think garlic dough may end up being a game changer in this spot. Wheat flour, garlic, and sunflower oil. That's right, it's pretty expensive to make, isn't it? We're gonna try this now. We still have like 3-4 hours left of possible bream time. Wheat flour, garlic, sunflower oil. Crap. Where's the sunflower oil? Cheese cubes. I don't know that there's a cheese we can get here that works with it though, right? Melted cheese doesn't work. I'm almost certain. Is it just the cheese at Quarry? Which it's no big deal. I mean, we can buy cheese, but cheese might be cheaper overall to make than garlic dough. We'd have to check. We'd also have to have a reason to go to Quarry, though. Get garlic dough out there and just see what happens. What is this? Now, oftentimes in bream spots, with the right bait, you would still expect to catch one or two decent bream this late in the morning, or this early in the morning. Let's see if that's the case for us. Alright, come on. Come on, garlic dough, show us something. Give us a little bit of hope. Uh-oh. Heck yeah. It's a nice looking bream. 2.7 kilos, 1300 experience. Garlic dough it is. All right. Well, it'd be interesting at this point to try a whole night in this spot. So maybe next time we can do that. I'll try to hold off for one more fish here and then we'll wrap it up. So cottage cheese and pea porridge are at 40%. Both of them can be good. I would say in more modern or recent times, pea porridge is probably stronger, but every once in a while cottage cheese, especially for bream, can be excellent. I think Volkov maybe has had the like times where cottage cheese has been really good for bream, but pea porridge has as well. Occasionally eyed too. Looks like we've got a fish trying to get on our front line. little guy. It's just gotten to be too late now. See if we got lucky on a bream order. I didn't even check before coming out, but we once again did not rake in the money, but I am optimistic about what we might do if we use garlic dough in that spot for a full night. Trophy bream order's up. That's too bad. We'll see what's worth more. A common roach trophy, slightly more than the 2-kilo bream. So 41 silver, slightly more than last time. Still not making enough to really be significant, but we're getting there. We'll try garlic dough next time. The other thing we could do is go test mosquito some. We'll see what kind of mood I'm in. As always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.